Hey there! Welcome to another episode of Dear Blocko. This is the show where I answer your questions about your world and my world. Let's get started with our first question. Kyle O asks, Dear Blocko, what happens when you get punched by a professional boxer? Well, my guess is that it would hurt. A lot. Just take a look at a boxing or mixed martial arts match, and you could see the kind of devastation that a punch can put on the body. If enough happens, a good enough punch can lead to broken bones. That's dependent on a number of factors, like the force behind the punch and where it lands, but those broken bones can happen on either side. That's because while somebody on the other end of the punch may end up with a broken jaw or a black eye, the person throwing the punch is also at risk for breaking bones in their wrist or hand. Broken knuckles, also known as metacarpal fractures, are fairly common, leading to the term boxer's fracture or brawler's fracture. Getting punched in the head can knock you out for a variety of reasons, but a big one has to do with how the impact of the blow can cause your head to spin or whip around. Your head's sudden acceleration, followed by its quick deceleration, as your muscles and tendons try to prevent it from spinning further, may cause your brain to slam into its skull, potentially multiple times. That trauma can cause a bunch of neurotransmitters to fire at once, essentially overloading your nervous system and knocking you out. Question 2 comes from Mr. Mickey 19, and they ask, Dear Blocko, what causes thunder and lightning? Well, there's a lot going on to make all of this happen, but basically, lightning is caused by ice crystals in the clouds flowing up and down and crashing into each other. This collision strips some of their electrons, ultimately separating the positive and negative charges of the cloud. Now, the top of the cloud is positively charged, while the base of the cloud is negatively charged. With the whole opposites attract thing, the negative charges at the bottom of the cloud want to connect with the ground's positive charges. Eventually, the positive charges from something on the ground, like a pole, tree, or even a person, connects with the negative charges reaching down from the clouds, and voila, you got lightning, and a thunderous boom to go with it. And now it's time for questions about me and my world. Jennifer Swift asks, Dear Blocko, what is something you cannot live without? Well, I'd be nothing without my animator. Thank you, animator, I love you. I also can't live without my friends. Thank you, friends, I love you. And I also can't live without electricity. Seriously, keep that electric bill paid, animator. I have videos to make. Timothy Gaming asks, Dear Blocko, can you tell us more about the corrupted blocks in your world? Well, those glitch monsters were created when a corrupt blocky being in my world started infecting other people. They keep infecting things in the Life Noggin world all the time now. Last year, Blocko, they got loose, and I've been trying to find them. Aha! Got one. Animator, could you take care of this, please? Thank you so much. I'm gonna keep hunting for these glitch monsters and try to get rid of them, and while I'm doing that, why don't you ask me more questions down in the comment section below, and make sure you use the hashtag DearBlocko so I can find it. Wanna watch even more Dear Blocko? Check out the previous one we did. Dear Blocko, what happens if you go to sleep mad? Well, much of what happens when you sleep is a mystery, but if you're feeling worried or tense before bed, falling asleep and staying asleep can be much harder. As always, my name is Blocko, this has been Life Noggin. Don't forget to keep on thinking.